Hey, folks, we're in Langley, and we're with Randy of Hempies. How you doing?
I'm doing fabulous, Remo. How about yourself?
I'm doing great. Smoked a great joint out back. So,
I know. I really enjoyed that. And now we're going to go on a little tour around Hempies and show people what the place is like. How's that sound?
It sounds awesome. Where do you want to start?
Well, let's start here with this Heady Glass.
Yes, yeah, the Heady Glass.
God, you know, this is really sort of the signature with Hempies. We love the Heady Glass. We're really such strong supporters. I mean, but look at this stuff. It's fantastic.
Okay.
You know, we represent a lot of the artists. We've got them all labeled, which made it really nice. People then have an opportunity to get to know who these people are.
Yeah.
Often it's kind of a mishmash when you go in, but this way, you know, I look at Blaze's work up here. Fantastic stuff.
And, oh, yeah.
You know, by identifying it, people get to know the quality and sort of how they like to do their work. So that's really what we like to try to bring here is more knowledge and a lot of fun,
yeah.
And which is Hempies, you know. So then
cool.
Coming around.
Actually,
here,
I want to look a little more at this.
Oh, you like this, eh?
Got some great stuff here. Got some junk. Got some Nico. I had a couple Nico pieces.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful stuff. Hippo work, you know, fantastic. Very, very much a signature work that this guy does. Stebby's work is so diverse, from that ribbon work back there, which is absolutely fantastic.
It's beautiful.
Around to things that are spiked and, you know, ribbons on them. And his diversity as an artist is second to nobody. I would have to say, I don't like to pick favorites, but Stebby's always been the guy. I love that brother.
I like your fluid motion piece here.
Yes, yeah.
That's really nice.
You betcha. There's a great story behind that one there. It took that individual, it took him years to learn how to make this. Kept trying, and every time he would do this work, as it would, you know, harden, it would crack. Mm-hmm. So he tried it for a few years and gave up on it. Eventually went back and was able to determine the right thicknesses of all of these pieces.
Yeah.
So as it's cooling, it cools at the same rate and wouldn't crack. It took him years to be able to come up with that, and that's become really one of his signature pieces.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, no kidding. Very complex, you know. It's and they play with it like plasticine.
Yeah.
Which is quite incredible.
I like some of the colors here with the Hetman glass here.
Yeah.
Some nice looking stuff.
You betcha.
The red beard.
Yes.
You got some of the red beard stuff?
Well, of course. Well, you got to have it. You know, I mean, the beard is, he's been around for years. You know, he led, I think, a lot of this. You got me inspired.
Well, look at the glass gathering. Yeah. That attracts artists from everywhere.
From everywhere, yeah. We really support, you know, the glass gathering and always have. And so, you know, so I guess we've almost really become like patrons of this art craft. So,
indeed, and a collector too.
Yeah, that's kind of what ends up happening.
Piles of it.
Oh my gosh, yeah, you know, but it's so gorgeous.
I got some solid flow here.
You bet.
And here we'll get the
Vagabond
at the back there.
In the back.
With the eyeballs.
You bet. Iceberg, you know, is sort of his classic penguin work. And, you know, that's what's, like I say, wonderful when you show off the work and you put a name next to it.
Yeah.
You get to know really what their signature is, you know, and they all develop something and they're quite unique. And, you know, all very, very, you know, we have some amazing artists here on the West Coast.
We do.
We are really quite blessed. Yeah. So now we'll come over here. I want to show you. This is more.
Okay.
What we get over here is,
holy.
Yeah, we got the carpet.
How you doing?
Oh, this is Sarah. She's recently started
nice to
here.
Nice meet you.
Yeah, she recently started with Hempies, another one of the happy crowd.
Right on.
And,
so you're a glass expert then?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
The smartest.
Yeah. Perfect. That's perfect. Okay, what are we looking at here in this case?
Well, these are all the carb caps, you know, so these are manufactured or produced by all the artists. This
right.
is also trying to work with them. We do have some products, of course, down here that are actually manufactured,
of course,
in warehouse, bangers and stuff like that. And then, of course, a whole series of pendants.
Oh, pendies.
From all of the different artists that are around,
holy
too. So
cow.
Quite an accumulation of artwork over the years that, you know, we've been able to bring in, you know, which just makes it nice. And then, you know, back behind you here, a great selection. You know, and then we have featured artists. These were individuals that we met at the glass gathering, you know, so we bring in their work and try
right.
to highlight what it is they do. Try to get people interested in this sort of, this craft. What's been really wonderful is so many of these artists now have been able to compete with offshore glass.
Right.
And so this is what we try to help people understand is that if you're spending an extra $10 on that pipe, do know it was handmade by somebody. Locally, it's got a lot going into it, and it'll probably last you a long time. Thick
yeah.
walls, better pipe. So the little bit of investment, it definitely pays off. It's going to
buy
a
Canadian
one-off.
For sure.
Well,
right?
buy Canadian for sure, and it's a yeah. one-off. You know, it's not something that's just been, you know, chinged out. So we really do that. You know, we do have a lot of, like I say, a lot of different glass available. Roar. So there's a lot of different price points. You know, recognizing that when people come into, you know, this environment, is we want to make it open and available to people from, you know, a sort of economy, so that there'll be that, and then there's a mid-range, and then premium brands.
So you got something for everybody here.
Something for everybody. That's been really important with Hempy's right from the very beginning, was make sure that anybody and everybody come in here and feel welcome and at home.
Cool.
So, yeah, you know, so.
Okay, so this case here is
These are a lot of rigs, and of course, a lot of this is offshore glass.
Okay.
But I must say, you know, much of the glass now that's coming in from offshore is really being produced or overseen by Canadian or American companies.
You're the one with the donut.
Yeah, so the quality has really come up. Not a concern like the old days where maybe we're unsure of the pedigree of the glass, if I can say that, whether there was going to be toxins in it. So even offshore glass, I think, has really improved. But of course, we're able to take that.
Well, it's competition, right?
Yeah.
This is what they're competing with. Like, look at that.
Yeah, we've got our local artists that can also produce all the rigs that you would like. And, you know,
at good prices, too.
Really good prices. You know, so it's very competitive. In terms of what people would want to get, you know, so we do try to make it available to everybody.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Holy crap, there's so many pieces here. How many pieces have you got all together?
Well, you know, I think that different SKUs, because as you can notice on our shelves or even everything that you've seen here, there's no repeats.
Right.
So we have thousands. I mean, I think maybe it could be close to 10,000 individual pieces back here. You know, different colors, different looks, different design. But, you know, we could have maybe gone and just filled a whole shelf with the same bong.
Right.
But no, like I say, you look at any of these shelves, if there's 12 bongs on a shelf, they're 12 different bongs. It's really neat. So that, I think, is our signature, trying to represent what this culture is. It's so diverse. It's so broad. We should, you know, I'm very proud of what we are and what we can offer. So, and Hempy's is all about that.
I think our whole culture has come a long way.
Oh, gosh, we have.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We have our own artists, our own economy, our own music.
Very much so.
Our own, you know, textiles even.
You bet, yeah. No, it's remarkably diverse, and that's really what, you know, I've tried to do right from the beginning with Hempy's, was to represent everything. This was Hempy's Gifts and Novelties. So it's from, you know, as we were coming, where we'll see later on here, all of the different items we carry, which could be from cosmetics to t-shirts to coffee mugs, around to getting all of this too. So tried to gather up everything from what our culture is, you know, puzzles even. So, I love this. How could I not? Eh? How could you not?
I'm totally into it too. See, you got a wide variety of rolling papers.
Yes.
For, I guess, the old timers that still like to roll joints. Like
yeah, you know what? There's still a lot of people that really do like to smoke their joints, and even with smoking not being the most popular thing, there's nothing quite like smoking a joint. You really got to smoke it.
It's okay,
you know, shatters and, you know, using vaporizers, which I use a lot, and I think a lot of us do. There's still nothing quite like the full-bodied nature of a high when you actually smoke it.
Yeah.
It definitely is full-bodied. How's that sound?
I enjoy the whole experience. Grinding it up,
you bet.
Rolling
it's much more social and all that aspect. But no. So, no, papers are rollies are still a big part of our culture, and I don't think it's ever going to go away.
For sure.
Yeah.
So what do you got in the next cabinet? Oh, well, things for joints by the looks of it.
Well, you know,
grinders.
Well, of course, grinders and all of that goes along. So this is all the additionals that you would need.
Yeah.
One hitters. I'd say everything. We try to cover all the price points so that nobody's going to be left out. You know, this isn't a place that's just sort of exclusive to only a certain group. It's not about that. So we've really covered the bases. If you've got, you know, if you want to come in, you only got a dollar to spend, I assure you there's something in here for you. It just makes it really fun, you know.
Nice.
Yeah. So,
what's this case full of?
This one here is offshore hand pipes. So
okay.
We do carry a selection of them, just so that they're widely available. But it also allows people to see what offshore glass really is. So they can get a sense of looking at that. It's nice, but it's fairly homogenous in terms of its colors and its look.
Yeah.
Then we move over here into the next case, which is, once again, these are all Canadian artists.
There we go.
And you begin to see the diversity in all the different expressions, different colors, different thoughts that go into it. So, and as you can see, we've got all the different names, all of these artists that Hempy's is so blessed to be able to support. And
tons of heady glass.
Oh, yeah.
This keeps going on and on and on.
It's wonderful.
Kahuna.
Yeah. Yeah, there's so many people producing, you know, beautiful stuff.
Gibson.
Yeah.
I was using one of those pipes today.
You bet. And then, of course, you know, you've got your acrylics, you know, any of that. And then now, of course, you're getting into the silicone, which are really nice for a travel bong.
Yeah, it's smash proof.
Yeah, exactly. They're kind of nice. You know, they're different to use. I'm not really all that keen on. I do like glass. There's something nice about that. But these are really handy for a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Then, of course, you get into your soft glass, which in many ways are just grandma's vase with a pipe, with a pipe pot. You know,
cool.
That's all you can do. So
starter bong.
Yeah, that's the thing. This now, Noble Glass, they come out of Oregon. Now, they've taken soft glass to a whole new level.
Actually, look at these marbles.
Yeah, they're absolutely incredible. Their pricing is very, very good. Magnificent work. But they do everything out of sort of that, where they work with molten glass, as opposed to a lot of these artists here work with boro, you know, sort of preformed glass, and they melt it and form it. They're more called what they called lamp workers. So when you get into this, this is the old style where it's molten glass, and they produce all of this and then wrap things, and it's quite
beautiful.
Spectacular. Really, truly is.
Very nice stuff.
Know? So, and then, of course,
more heady glass.
Well, more heady glass. I mean, you know, well, there's more people that, you know, their work, well, what they can do, you know, Gibson's work, you know, here's Kahuna. All of his Scalian. I mean, we've got, like, you know, a whole family here, for God's sakes.
Scalian.
I mean, it's incredible. Yeah. So, you know, a lot of different.
Skullfish,
yeah. Very technical.
Makes some great stuff. I got a few of those pieces. Look at this, a vapor swing.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
What I think started that the whole dab revolution.
Yeah, with that one there, that was one of the first pieces that we purchased here at Hempy's when I kind of got around a lot of his glass.
Right.
And so, you know, the wig-wag work in this is absolutely incredible. It's old school, but this thing is, I mean, truly, truly a work of art. Usable art, very clearly. You know, you can use something like that and not be afraid of damaging it.
Nice.
You know, as all of this, you know.
It's functioning art.
It truly is, yeah. You know, so. And then, of course, we move over to this side here.
Vapes.
You know, we've got all of the different vapes that are available, you know, that are in the market today.
These ones are really good.
Of this type of thing are really.
Oh, these are premium right here.
Yeah, yeah. So we try to do, we like people to understand in terms of all of what this is having to do with bud.
Right.
So, okay, so what we've done here, we try to people understand is that when they're coming in, they might not be well-versed, and how do we help them appreciate what these products are about? And so we've come up with this entry level, a mid-range, and a premium level.
Makes sense to me.
Well, I think, you know, if somebody's got a bit of an understanding or maybe sort of a semi-regular user, well, maybe they would want to get a mid-range. But if it's your very first kick at the can, we don't want people to invest a certain amount of money in something that they may not actually enjoy using.
Yeah.
You know, so we don't want to mislead them or somehow exploit them just because they're here.
Absolutely.
I feel it's better to build, you know, sort of positive relationships with any customer or anybody that you're around. So that's what we've done here for all of sort of like, you know, the herb ones.
There's
of course, your volcanoes or, you know, they're sort of a mainstay. They were the ones that really. Now we're getting into sort of all of your extracts, you know. So this is another cabinet so that people can go through and see all of the different, you know, ways, delivery systems for using extracts. And right up to the Puffco Peak. You know, and once again, helping people understand the difference between all of the products or what you're purchasing, you know, the entry level, you can get something like that for like $30 or $40. And that's probably a good place to start
if you're
not sure. It really is. We explain to them, okay, you're probably not going to give you the best taste, and I wouldn't recommend using this over long term. They do start in about the $30 range. But then, as you know, as you really want to get up into the Puffco Peak, no different than the Volcano.
No.
Now you're getting up to the high end.
And it's a premium unit.
It is. You're probably going to have to spend $500 or $600. It's a bit of an investment, but they're wonderful products, and if it's something that you're a regular user, I have a Puffco Peak.
Me too.
I love the thing. I really do. It's great. You can take it with you.
Yeah.
Beautiful, sitting on the table.
Great for dabbing on the go.
It is all of that, isn't it? You know, so we have all of that too. And then
notice you have hookah pipes too.
Oh gosh, yeah.
And Andy.
There he is. Yeah. Yeah. So there's, you know.
And more pipes.
This is some early Redbeard, this one here.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that was some very early stuff. And you know, lots of different artists that we've picked up over the years. And, you know, just really like to sort of like I say, once again, show off all their work. Scales.
Got some scales.
Got all your scales, you know. And then, of course, you know, as you look around, all
Z-bolts for storing.
Yeah, all your Z-bolts. We've got, you know, everything you would need.
Jars,
everything, storage. You know, things that are fun to store, too. You know, even some funny little matches, you know, which are just kind of, you know, silly stuff. So we've really tried here at Hempy's to really broaden the base so that there's, like I say, that this place is open to everybody. You don't have to, you don't have to be a user, but maybe you got, like, you know, I don't know, maybe a nephew or a crazy uncle or your parents, for God's sakes. Well, you can come in here and you can find something fun for them. You know, so we've really, like I say, tried to make sure that this place is open and available to everybody.
Cool.
Yeah.
What else we got? Clothing.
Yeah, we got clothing over there. You know, all down that side, cosmetic.
Is it hemp clothing?
Yeah, there's this, these are all hemp clothing here. This is Efforts. It's a Canadian company. Fantastic stuff. Very, very well priced. You know, under $50 for a shirt like this.
Very affordable.
Very, very affordable.
And
washes washes up nice. And the beauty of also it is that these fashions, because they've been made by a Canadian company, they've been made for a Canadian body.
Right.
I don't know if many of us remember, but in the old days when you would go out and buy a hemp shirt, usually they were too big around this way, they were short around the waist, and the arms were too short. It was because they were coming from China. They were made for a Chinese man's body.
Okay.
And that's all it is. That's truly what's happening with it. Now, Efforts really took a hold of that and said, you know what, we're going to make stuff that is intended for a North American body, let's say, rather than Asian body. Different body types.
Absolutely.
You know, most definitely. So they really led, I think, the charge in it, and, you know, so we've been able to do that. But then, you know, we also bring in other products that you can see that, you know, are very high-end, represent the culture, you know.
Nice
the,
buds.
Yeah, really nice buds, you know. So it's really good companies. Really nice.
Cool.
Yeah.
You've got some creams and lotions, too?
Creams, lotions, cosmetics, purses, you know, other types of T-shirts. And then, of course, a full selection of novelties, games, puzzles, storage tins, odor eliminator candles, all these little things. And then, of course, we also carry grow tents now, which has been really a wonderful thing as happening here in Canada.
Everybody's allowed to grow four plants
everybody's
legally.
Everybody's allowed to grow four plants legally. And so why wouldn't you?
I know.
It's become so economical with what these are. And they're a plug and play. You can plug them into a 120. They use less power than a space heater, significantly less. This one over here will use maybe 300 watts. A space heater is 1,000 to 1,500, and you can plug that into a wall. So just to give people a reference, you're not going to have to be worried about anything. Come fully with the fan, filters, very, very little heat, so you don't have to be concerned about having air conditioning. Magnificent. So this is really a good
company. A complete grow tent, ready to go.
Complete, yeah. This Indo, really good company. It's a Canadian company.
Yeah.
Interestingly enough, was looking around, it's kind of a volatile market.
Yeah.
Found them. They're right here in Langley.
Perfect.
So, yeah, so it was
kind of
one of those. It just happened to be doing, you know, the Google search. And then, of course, because we do like to carry, you know, all, everything that's of real great quality, I think, that people have seen, well, then, of course, we have to carry Remos. I mean,
Randy.
Really, if you want to end up with the best, you've got to start with the best, Remo. You know that.
Absolutely.
You
know, it puts everything.
It really does. So
gold in,
for
gold
us,
out.
This whole idea of marrying, you know, these two things together, bringing Hempy's along, I mean, watching you come forward as another great Canadian brand, is for us, it's an exciting time, Remo. I really have welcomed you into our store. And
well, thanks for having us, thanks for carrying our products. This is awesome.
It's been fantastic. And in terms of, you know, the community around us, you're pretty well known. So we do have a lot of people coming in. We introduce them to your brand. We can speak confidently of your brand, too. So, I mean, that's something we all can thank you for, is that you allow us to speak in a positive way.
Cool.
To know that you've got a good brand, a good product. So if people want to start with something like this, that they can step into this and feel confident that they're not going to damage their plants or damage themselves. So like I say, you know, if you want to end up with the best, I think you've got to always start with the best.
Absolutely.
And, that's what you're doing, Raymond.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for everything, and thanks for the tour.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
Yeah. Randy, if somebody wanted more information about Hempy's, where would they go?
Well, if you want to have a little look at us, you can go online, www.hempy's, and that's Hempy's with a Z,
.com.
We do have Instagram. We do have Facebook. You can find us there. We do have two locations in the Langleys, one in the township, one in the city. This one in the township, this is our flagship store. It's got, I mean, it's representative of everything. And then we've got one down on the one way in Langley, which is much more of a culture shop. So if you want things that, more posters and things that are kind of akin to that, we tried to create a store that fits into that community. So that's awesome. Really where we're at.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, I got one more question. Randy, do you know what time it is?
I think it's time to go smoke another joint.
Indeed. It's time to smoke a huge joint. But in the meantime, keep watching Urban Rainbow for more weed videos. Thanks for the tour.